So they have not any team we know for. Now my boy is the coordination team, but we are ready. Full club, hang back, full game load. Anyway, I feel that band will be more than father, you walk with the other guys. Because they should bust up. Hang back, CGI, you should join me. So you know what I mean, you know what I mean, you know what I mean. So all them are there, you go across here. That area, you have to be more support. So since you have one year ago, you have to pay. Band will talk about you.
Deglu la nga jël GRTS English jël olof ba oh short one in English nga jël olof haram risk question be pare do la may
ke you may run Okay, first of all, tell us your name.
My name is Betty Sam. I'm a senior communication officer for
our Fatima Barrow
Foundation.
What prompted the need to respond to this call?
The Fatima Barrow Foundation is a charity organization. Organization that touches so many areas in this country. Health is the foundation's main priority, and when you're talking about health, you're talking about cleanliness. So anything that's going to make our plan a success and then contribute a lot to the aim that the foundation has, we would call it an emergency call, and this was one of them, and then that's why the foundation responded very quickly.
We've gone for the old environment.
The foundation is very concerned, particularly with Her Excellency. I would say this needs a lot of resources. There's a lot of resources that would make this a success. And then the foundation, in collaboration with the mayor of Banjul, would work hand in hand to make sure we have the Banjul that we want.
What message do you have for the BCC and the people of Banjul?
To the mayors, I'm saying congratulations. And to the people of Banjul, I'm saying walk hand in hand, and then the Banjul that we want will be the capital city that every African will look up to, and then every Gambian will look up to. Thank you very much.
Thank you. From the
First and foremost, I want to say thank you very much to the First Lady and the foundation with the First Lady. What prompted this, you can remember that in the last 5 months, we were in a very hard campaign. And looking at Banjul, I think everybody will remember my slogan, Banjul sits at the emergency. And this is what, looking at the condition of Banjul, it has prompted this emergency call. And this is why we collaborated with the First Lady Foundation and all institutions to come in the aid of Banjul. We have four platforms. So we go to all institutions. Some of them are here, some of them don't respond at all. So for those who didn't respond, we know what bad means to them. So this is how we come together, and then from this platform, we will make this be a successful one.
This is the work that demanded me to do going through. I mean, what are the mechanisms that you guys are putting in place to ensure that when everywhere is going, where the CEO is going, 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 to ensure that people then start going to the
As Alaji just said, we have lots of mechanism. We have lots of mechanism in place. We are going to have these big tanks, about 1,100 liters that will come, and also the president has given us tractors. Not to us yet, but we are expecting them to be here very soon. So we rest assured that we are not using this for going to be in vain. We are going to put mechanisms in place that will make sure that the claim will totally be clean in the next 2 months.
Finish all this work.
Yeah, everything has a plan. We started with 21 days, but I can be rest assured that we have a manpower that will take us through for the next 6 days. We have the tax force, the security force that are totally behind us. They saw us that they love Banjul, and they are here to help. So other institutions that don't care about Banjul should make sure they pack and go. Enough is enough. We are prepared to let them pack and go. You know, it's not only to care about Banjul, but if you are operating in Banjul, I think your social responsibility should be so. But they don't even respond see the letters that BCC is writing here.
You and Her Excellency have taken a long walk today. Can you say in your name you've done a treadmill? Have you done anything, any exercise like this? Thank you very much.
Without them, freedom did not possible. RSK also did a lot. So we will go to the TV after everything to thank them. Can you do that? We are going out to say thank you to them.
And we are calling Banjulians and friends of Banjul in the diaspora. They have to pay their share. Social media, they have promised a lot. They have the capacity to put their hands in Banjul. Let them come and give hands to Banjul. In fact, I believe the Lord Mayor has been thinking of having a big fundraiser, if possible, inviting the Banjulians in the diaspora to come in and put the little they have in to Banjul, their money and their connections.
Their expertise.
She is calling the Banjulians in the diaspora. And we would reach you guys to come in. We would have a big information campaign so you all would know what is happening. And we would have a big fundraiser if possible. The PRO is here and would handle all that, I'm quite sure, because we would call the Banjulians in the diaspora to play their part. It's time to walk, not to talk. Inviting everybody.
Where is the piano?
Sandy. Sandy, he's over there. Yeah. Piano Sultan.
Well, some of the
I'm going to go to the house. Lady Fatuba Baro, because Nyari Jabar, so Malola believe it. This one is Jawara. Lafa am Lady Chilen, am Lady Lennon. So Malay Buga Moy. Iman Buga Punya.
Can you jalan?
All right, thank you very much.
So, Sherry Coco.
Lord Mayor, will go after him. Dara bul ko waral ni ci gannaaw rek
yeen ñaari jigeen yi bañu li amu bañu bari sax daay ñeñu
Bam again.
Thank you.